Hi everyone, it's Lisa here for Honeybee Stamps. In today's video, I'm sharing how I use the Spring Peony stamps and dies to create this watercolor look on vellum. Now, I'm going to give you a quick look here at that Spring Peony stamp set. Beautiful florals. Now, I'm going to place a piece of vellum in my Misty. I'm stamping the image using VersaMagic Night Sky ink. And I'm going to go ahead and cover that with clear embossing powder and go ahead and heat set it. Once I have that heat set, I'm going to go ahead and lay down a little bit of the VersaMagic Night Sky ink on my mat there. And I've just come in with a water brush to pick some of that color up and start adding it to the petals. Now, this is the first time I've ever attempted this technique, so I'm going to grab the VersaMagic Midnight Sky and I'm going to try to darken up some areas. Truthfully, I'm just pushing my limits here to see how far I can take this. So everything seems to be okay, and I think, hey, let's add something else to the mix. So I'm going to grab my Perfect Pearls, thinking a little shimmer never hurt, and maybe it'll help lighten up some areas. So I'm just going to take a brush and dip it in the little pot there, because I have two pots of Perfect Pearls, so I'm okay with using one by dipping a brush in it and then laying the Perfect Pearls down around the top of each petal. I'm loving the way this is looking. So I'm happy with the way all of this has turned out. I'm going to go ahead off screen and run all of those pieces through the die cut machine. Now what I did was I ran those through the machine, and then I took some white cardstock and added double-sided adhesive to one piece of it, and then cut out some extra pieces there. I want to be able to add the vellum to the white die cut pieces, and by adding that double-sided adhesive, it will make it so much easier to adhere the vellum to that white cardstock. The extra pieces I had left over, I'm just using those behind it to add some dimension to the card. So you can see here, I've been using some foam squares and foam circles to adhere the leaves and flowers to the front of the card. And I decided to come in with a little bit of twine and tie a tiny bow around that. Now, the background paper is some that I've had in my stash, but I did use the deckled edge honey cut dies, the largest one, to die cut that paper out. So my inspiration from this card came from a cake that I saw on Pinterest, and it was so beautiful. It just had some pink shimmer on it with just a tiny little flower on the front of it and twine, and I thought, you know, that would make a beautiful card. So a great place to find inspiration for your cards is literally to look at cakes on Pinterest. So I did go ahead and stamp and die cut that little word love from the piece of cake stamp and coordinating dies. And then I've just popped it up with a few foam circles. And here we go. We are all done. This card comes together so quickly. I was so amazed at how it turned out. I mean, who would have thought? Watercoloring with VersaMagic on vellum. You never know until you try, right? Okay, so let me know what you think about this in the comments below. Thanks for joining me today. I hope you'll click the subscribe button and ring the bell to be notified of new content to the channel. Now, for more information about the products used, head over to the Honeybee Stamps website, and I hope you have an amazing day.